Greetings, people of America and all over the world, but especially those in America. Paul Muckle here. Today is June 24th, 2011 at 11:04 p.m. Eastern Time. Right now, breaking news. New York State passes same-sex marriage bill. Becomes sixth state to legalize gay marriage. Okay, that's what's going on in America today, okay, people? That's the news. That's the big thing that these people are fighting over. Whether or not two consented adults have the right to marry. I mean, that's the people's business. Okay? The government needs to sell the people's bedrooms. Okay? Me personally, I don't care. I mean, before I had an issue with it before, but I don't care really because it's not hurting me. You know, a lot of they don't. The point I'm trying to make right is these men out there debating whether or not two consenting adults had a right to marry when for the past couple of years, millions, over 4, maybe 5 million Americans have been thrown out of their homes like dogs, like animals. Okay, they use your taxpayer dollar, America. They use your tax dollars. Okay, and bail out Wall Street and told these banksters to give you a loan modification. What these banksters did? They laughed at the government and gave their CEOs $1 million bonuses, golden parachutes, had lost parties. While Americans were being evicted by the thousands every day, what it was like 70,000 a month, Americans were being thrown out of their homes, and no one sit in Congress and no place debating. No one stay up till midnight debating what's going on in people's homes. No one did that, but they up almost midnight debating whether or not two adults have the right to marry. That's what's going on in America, people. Some of America is underwater. Okay? The American city is underwater right now. No one is up at almost midnight debating what to do. Debating to tell the people the truth and that it's the lies and deceptions. And this kind of crap that they're debating is what causing America to flood. No one is up telling the truth about that. They're debating whether or not two adults have a right to marry. But the point of this video wasn't to talk about that. That just happened to be on the TV when I was about to make this video. Because I was going to make a video to answer some questions to some of my friends, and I just bounced into this video in my files and I decided to make it. I want to talk about foreclosures, people. People in the next video are about to see, right? See, I am joined this group called Foreclosure Hamlet, right? It's a group of homeowners who got taken advantage of just like I did. These are professional people, very intelligent people, but we all got conned by the banks because the banks, we trusted the banks and they lied to us, basically. It's just like trusting a priest and he turned around and rape you. Same thing, you know, you didn't expect it. So we trusted these banks and these banks took advantage of us, and these people form a group and decided to help each other fight for their homes and to help all Americans. Non-profit organization. And when I met them, one of their founders, Dave Changa in Florida, he saw one of my videos and he brought me into the group. I met some wonderful people: Tony Webster, Jim Brody, Lisa, and I met a lot of nice people on there, and we became like family. But I don't know them that well because I was just in and out. But anyway, that group, they did some wonderful work They've been fighting for your people, fighting for people, and people don't even know it. And some members of the group, they lost their homes. They lost their home during this home foreclosure crisis, and no one helped them. The government didn't help them. The government of Ohio sat silent while these people's home was taken away from them. People that were evicted from their homes like criminals. I mean, wait till you see this video, people. Wait until you see this video. Now you know why, people. Now you know why I fight for people. Now you know why I stand up for everybody, because I'll be damned. Because this is what they're going to do to me, people. When they come to take my house, this is how they're going to have to take me out. Like this. Like you're about to see. Because they're going to come and try to take me from my home, people. They're going to try it. I know it. But it's okay, because the repercussions are going to be draconian. Because, as you recall, the tornado of June 1st that hit Massachusetts, that was just a taste. That was just a taste. Okay? That was just a warning shot across their brows. The next tornadoes will be with such more precision. They will be so directed, like surgical strikes. I know they're going to try to come and take me out of my home. And this is how they're going to do it, people. Watch, people. See for yourself why Palmer can stop and fight for everyone. This, people, is why I stop and fight for people. Because these people are like helpless. Where's the government? Why aren't they up debating almost midnight about why are people losing their homes? They're debating whether or not two men have a right to say I do, or two women have a right to have sex, or two men have a right to have sex and married. That's what they're debating. But look at our American family. Look how they are being victimized by the same government, by the sheriff, like criminals. People, this thing make my heart bleed. This is why I fight. This is why I would never give in. This is why they couldn't pay me $100 million to give up my case against them. This is why, people. You could never buy me Wall Street. And judges, I don't fear you. Because this is what you are going to have to do to me to get me out of my house. And when it happens, take it how you want it. The repercussions will be draconian. The Lord of hosts has spoken. The tornadoes will strike with more precision. Let it be a warning, people of America. This is what your government is going to bring down on you. The day they do this to me, they'll bring down storms in America and in England, over there in London, where Mr. Rothschild resides.